present to you an interesting hadith from our sixth Imam, Imam Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam. It's a hadith which comes from a very prominent Shia scholar, was a famous muhaddith scholar of hadith by the name of Shaykh Saduq. And the hadith of the Imam is very, very simple but very meaningful also and relevant to us. But it says, Ash-shita rabi'ul mu'min. Ash-shita, the winter season. It says, the winter season is rabi'ul mu'min. It is a spring season for a mu'min. Now how do you look at winter, especially in Toronto, and consider that to be spring? You know, with the cold of the winter, the extreme weather that we have, Imam says the winter season becomes the rabi', the bahar and spring for a mu'min. What is spring? Spring symbolizes rebirth, renewal, or regrowth as far as the earth and the environment is concerned. You know, it is the spring season where you see the blossom of the plants and the flowers. Even when you look at the animal world, some of the animals who go into, you know, hibernation and during the winter time, they become more active and start their normal activities with the spring season. Even the earth itself, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran, He says, you know, we revive or give life to the dead earth. He's talking about the annual ritual where during the time of spring, the earth becomes alive, starts producing things, it has its own movement, whereas in winter that was not the case. So it's in that light that we look at this hadith, where the Imam says, Ash-shita rabi'ul mu'min. The winter season is the rabi, is the spring and a bahar for a mu'min. What does it mean? He explains. You know, he says, look at shita, what happens in the winter season? يَطُولُ فِيهِ لَيْلُهُ. Its night becomes long. وَيَقْصُرُ فِيهِ نَهَارُهُ. And its days become shorter. So you have longer nights in winter, shorter days in winter. Now how does that relate to this concept of the shita becoming a rabi and spring for a mu'min? This is where Imam explains it. He says, يَطُولُ فِيهِ لَيْلُهُ. During the winter times, the nights become longer. And what happens? With a longer night, فَيَسْتَعِينُ بِهِ عَلَىٰ قِيَامِهِ. Longer nights gives you the opportunity to stand up, to do your nawaf, to do the extra namaz that we have, because it's a long night time. For example, when we talk about namaz al-shab, preferable to recite it before Fajr. Fajr becomes later in winter. So there's more, you know, likelihood of people doing namaz al-fajr at its best prime time in winter rather than in summer. And then Imam says, فَيَسْتَعِينُ بِهِ عَلَىٰ سِيَامِهِ وَيَقْصُرُ فِيهِ نَهَارُهُ. And the days are shorter in winter. And so how does it become a rabi for a mu'min? On a spiritual level, this season becomes a more productive season for a mu'min. The days are shorter. فَيَسْتَعِينُوا بِهِ عَلَىٰ صُيَامِهِ. With the shorter days, you can fast more easily. Referring to mustahab or qaza, you know, fast. And this is where we have to realize that, you know, Imam is saying that, yes, not all the mu'mineen would be on the same level, or even those who are at a higher level of spirituality, whether they can maintain the same momentum through the whole year? No. There are some times when it's more easy. There are times when it is more difficult. And this is what Imam is saying, Ash-shita rabi'ul mu'min. The winter time is the bahar, is the spring for a mu'min, for his spiritual development.